Hi, everybody. Welcome back to our second webisode series this week. My name is Dr. Adam Christman. I'm the Chief Veterinary Officer here with Fetch DVM 360. And I have three wonderful guests with me today. We're going to be talking about curbside concierge customer service in the midst of COVID-19. So hello to my guests here.
Hey, everybody.
Let's get a little more information about you guys. So say hello to Dr. Stacy Santee. Dr. Santee is a 96 graduate from Colorado State University and founder of Vet2Pet, a technology startup that builds personalized custom apps for veterinary practices. With over 20 years of clinical experience in small animal and emergency practice, Dr. Stacy brings an in-the-trenches approach to innovation and solutions for veterinary teams. She has also served as medical advisory consultant for NVA for 5 years, medical director for a general ER practice in Colorado, as well as the current president of the Colorado Veterinary Medical Association. Welcome, Dr. Santee.
Hi, everybody.
So glad you're here. Also joining us is the one and only Dr. Caitlin DeWild. Dr. DeWild holds her DVM degree from the University of Illinois College of Veterinary Medicine, where she was the president of the Veterinary Business Management Association. With a long interest in business, marketing, and practice management, Dr. DeWild created the Social DVM in 2013, an interactive social media platform connecting pet parents to the veterinary healthcare team. Welcome, Dr. DeWild.
Thank you. Happy to be here.
And in addition, we have another celebrity, Dr. Catherine Prim. She is the owner and founder and chief vet at Applebrook Animal Hospital, which opened up in 1998. She's a certified veterinary practice manager and the nation's first fear-free certified professional as of 2016. She sits on the fear-free advisory panel, and she's the host of Nine Lives with Dr. Cat, and also Dr. Cat Gone to the Dogs on Pet Life Radio. She's a national conference speaker at Fetch and other conferences. She's a freelance writer and resident vet for iHeart Dogs and iHeart Cat since 2015. And she's the author of a book, Tennessee Trails, Pets and Their People, published in 2013. In addition, she's a blogger, a media personality, running interviews. She's been featured on Women's Day, Prevention and Health magazine. Welcome, Dr. Cat.
Hey, thanks for having me.
Yeah, doctors, this is a great conversation in with regards to the serious pandemic that is going on with COVID-19. And all of you have incredible experience with developing and building the pet parent experience. And there's a lot of concern right now that that's going to get compromised. And we're going to talk specifically about the curbside concierge pickup. But overall, what has the overall perception been with the pet parents that you've been experienced during this crisis? How has it been coming across as?
I think they're kind of liking it. I mean, I think we're finally expediting some care. And I think they've wanted that for a long time, and we haven't really taken it to the level we needed to in the trenches. So I'm kind of, in general, my perception is that as humans, we've ratcheted down a few notches on our expectations of one another in the world, and it feels kind of good.
Yeah. I think our clients have been, my practices have been, there was initially like a, wait, what is this? Do we really need this? There was that initial kind of early on, like, you know, they have had such an expectation of what they've always done, right? And it felt different for them for a little bit. But once things started to get kind of serious, I felt that was a pretty abrupt switch. And now they're just so grateful that we're still able to care for their pets while keeping them safe. So that's been my experience overall. It started off a little rocky, but now I think everybody figured everything out and started realizing the severity of this and has smooth sailing since then. How about you, Kat?
I've had a lot of people thank me for caring about them. And I had a client on the first day, and he said, you know, we're older and we're the at-risk group, and we really appreciate that you are still taking care of our dog and still taking care of us. And like I always say, relationships are kind of my thing. Like I love my clients, and I love staying with them throughout the lifetime of their pets. And this is something that we needed to do. The only negative pushback I've gotten from all of the COVID things are that people don't really love that we are not booking elective things right now. But the curbside has been a very positive thing.
So tell me more about that then. What are some things that you guys are doing that's giving that, you know, curbside concierge drop off?
We numbered our parking places. We put numbers 1, 2, 3, you know, and then we put a laminated sign that says call when you arrive. And that has really been a tip that has made this so much easier. The first day I wandered through the parking lot going, ladies, mom, you know, so the numbers really have helped.
That's a great tip. Yeah, Stacy, actually, I got this idea from Vet to Pet of having a sign made that basically said it sits in front of the parking space and it says call or text when you arrive and we'll come out to greet you. I think that's been really helpful. And to be truthful, I think it will stay long after the COVID thing because there's been a lot of people that have commented on that. Even myself, I have two little kids and if I didn't have to like get them out of the car to just come in and drop a sample off or to pick up a prescription, that would have been huge. And we've had so many people say things along those lines. But having that sign and the call and text has been really helpful.
I think the ability for the innovation I've seen around payment collection has been really fantastic too, because we're moving away from our traditional let's check you out at the lobby while you stand there and wait and I swipe your card. And, you know, we've really moved to more consideration and implementation of digital payment links. And I think that's brilliant because guys, the checkout process in general has been just a total hot mess, in my opinion, for many years. And it's something that takes a long time and it shouldn't. When people are ready to give you the money, you need to get that money quickly and get them out the door so you don't end on a bad note with this long drawn out payment. I don't know if you guys have ever experienced this, but you know, like you've been at a restaurant and you're done, right? Then you can't pay to get out and you just sit there and it kind of puts a damper on the whole fun event. And we've been guilty of that in our practices. So this has caused us to innovate and implement in a way that I think our clients really will enjoy.
And what are some, I know you work for Vet to Pet, let's just say, and I know, Kate, you implement, you have it at your practice. So how does that elevate the pet parent experience?
I'll let Kat take that. She's probably done more of it with the app and the loyalty aspects of it. But I think, especially now.
Yeah, I really love it. It's one of my favorite things. I've had a lot of clients indicate that they were really happy that we offer the mobile app and the loyalty rewards. And that direct communication with us through Vet to Pet is something that a lot of my techie clients really appreciate. I was going to say, though, in answer to what Dr. Santee said, you know, we had already moved our checkout process into the exam rooms for fear-free purposes because we recognized that the bottleneck at the checkout was a problem for fear for pets, like a cat in a box coming face-to-face with a dog, you know, being walked out. So we had already implemented that. So we basically moved our checkout process from the exam room out car side and, you know, for this COVID thing. And that's what we've been doing. And that's been working.
Mm-hmm. Oh, anybody else going to add to it or no? I didn't know.
I think just having having an app or having any kind of technology that takes up the real estate of your practice, representing your practice on their phone, they have a one-click button to get to the practice and all of its offerings. That's a convenience offering. And I think right now, but realistically for most of us all the time, convenience is a huge factor. Like, how can I possibly make this efficient? How can I get in and out without touching or seeing as many people as possible? How can I get the information to them and they can get the information to me? I think all of those things are just so important to centralize if we can. And again, just continue to show the value of what we're offering and what we're bringing to the clients. I think that's just, I think it's even more heightened now than ever before.
Well, I think one of the I think one of the beauties of an app is that you can create a captive audience between you and your clients. And this is where email is going to fail you right now. This is because you don't, guess what? You might not even, you probably don't have all your current, your clients' current emails. This is where you might not have all their text numbers in your practice software. So, you know, we're hearing from lots of people that say, I'm so glad that I have people that have downloaded my app. I've been working on this because now I can reach them and they can reach me, and we're kind of in our own little world. And I even have a practice in Hawaii that doesn't have a practice management system. They just don't. And they've been running on paper all these years, and they have our app. And they love it because when the hurricane comes, they can communicate with people. Here's what we're doing. And they've got a lifeline, and their people can come back and communicate with them. So I think this is something we're going to see as we move out of COVID into our new reality, is practices are going to want this kind of technology so they can protect and communicate with their own clients and fulfill their goal of taking care of those patients.
And what about, what do you guys have to say about those kind of pet owners or pet parents that aren't necessarily good listeners, but are better hearing things a different way, or I need something written, or you always hear like the, well, my, I'm the husband, but I, and tell my wife, and I forget, was it twice a day, twice, three times a day? When do I start the medications?
You sound like you've practiced.
Yeah. Right, it's not our first rodeo hearing these things, right? What are some things that you guys hear or suggest that would help kind of secure like compliance essentially during this time of COVID?
I think the written, adding the written aspect, because at least for us in our practice, what we're typically doing is calling them from the room, and we're just trying, we're like holding the dog, and we, you know, it's a little clunky still, right? And so we're still, you know, getting information from one person, and then we're like, okay, everything's great, we're gonna send them back out. And it's been hard not to make that seem like an assembly line service. So one of the things that we've done is we did this before to some degree, but we've had a better, I think, compliance of both the veterinary team and also the pet owners actually reading them, of doing a written report card, so that we can say, okay, here's what we did today, just because you didn't see it, but we really did it. Here's what we did. This is what we found. This is what we're recommending. Here's our next steps. This is a medication. And here's when we're going to see you again. And I think giving them that report when you hand back the dog, I think is kind of added value. Sometimes I haven't been able to get them out that quickly, so emailing them the report later, I think, has been a great way to really reinforce what we're doing, but also provide them that value in a way they can understand. Because they might be like, you know, okay, I'm in a car, I got to go, you know. So I think there's just some of those little things that we can try to meet everybody's knowledge, how they want to get their information, I guess.
Well, here's a good idea. One of our colleagues, Dr. Krista Wallace, she's been doing telemedicine. She's an early adopter type. She's been doing it for 3 or 4 years. And she said one of the things her clients absolutely love when she delivers kind of a telemedicine and visit, or we can also apply this in curbside, non-human present, non-owner present exams, is a little video recording synopsis. Just a little like, hey guys, it's Dr. Stacy. I just wanted to let you know I examined Fluffy and I found this, that, and this, and you're doing a great job, and I'm sending home this medication, and I'm here if you need me. I think putting a video out to that pet owner right now is still going to be a way for you to maintain that relationship.
I use the follow-ups. So I use the follow-ups in my practice management system all the time. And so we make sure that we set a follow-up for every patient. If it's a sick patient, we follow up to make sure that they're able to give the medications. If it's a sick patient, but you see something like today, I saw a dog for one thing, and I found severe periodontal disease as well. I went ahead and set a follow up to reach out to that owner 2 months from now and say, hey, you know what? The time has passed, but I bet you Peggy still has rotten teeth and we need to get on that. So take advantage of your follow-ups in your practice management software.
One of the things I would add too is some of these practices that may not be as busy, it's a good time to work on internally on your internal customer service too, to work on protocols, soaps, things that you maybe never had a chance to get done, to do, and then really hone in on those pet parents to really follow up, like you were saying, and checking on them, making sure that everything's okay, and really showing that bond to them during these times, because they need it more than ever.
If these practices are slow out there, and they are, some are for sure, this is a perfect time to start cleaning through your medical records. And what you want to do is you want to get all the patients that are due this month, say for wellness exam, and they can't come in because this stuff is on hold right now, but still call them. And you can offer to see if they need any refills of parasiticides or medication. This is going to be a revenue lifeline for us right now. You want to make sure that you're comforting them and letting them know that, hey, we got lots of food, we got lots of medicine, we're not going to run out, we're here if you need us. And you want to make sure while you're at it, do I have your right email address? Do I have your right number? Do you still have all these pets in your family? And let's go ahead and forward book you for September, because we expect that we'll be able to take care of you then. And now we're just deferring our revenue instead of losing it. So don't just send people home with nothing to do. You have, I know if you're like me, you've got a lot of help opportunity in this department where you could clean up your records. And plus, people just flat out like it if you call and say, I'm thinking of you. Are you okay? Anything I can do to help you? That is a very lovely thing to do right now in this world.
I think also marketing some of those convenience and some of the ways that you can help. So literally taking a screencast video of like your app or your website, this is where you go to get to the online pharmacy. If your pet needs food, here's literally exactly how to go in case they're a visual person. So creating some of those things, I think social media, of course, is a great way to get some of that information out. But people now need to know, how do they get their pets' medications? Is it from you or an online pharmacy? How do they get after-hours care? How do they get a refill on Fluffy's medications? And these are things that just take a few seconds to try to capture, either screencasts or even screenshots. Doesn't have to be a video, just to show people, here is the value that we're bringing. Even if you don't come here, we can still help you and your pet.
Yeah, I pulled a reminder report of everybody that was due for something. And then when this first started, everybody that was due for something in the next few months, and I reached out to them, whether it was email or phone calls or whatever. I mentioned our app, Stacey, I mentioned our Vet to Pet app, because that's a good way to reach people kind of in a quick way. And so I told them that. I told them we were offering telemedicine. I told them where to watch for updates, you know, check our website, check our app. And I just reached out. I used the practice management system to do that reminder report. And that's easy. Any of you guys could do that.
Mm-hmm. I think vets forget, like, your clients love you. They love their vet. And we're seeing that even now more so when people are stressed, they really know, you know, they value the veterinarian so much. We're often a part of their life in many ways. So you've got to keep educating and communicating with your clients. Just don't let up, because you want to comfort them. It's a way for you to really build that bond even stronger.
I agree. Like, the community is obsessed with us. You know, they love us. And now's the time, more so than ever, that we can really step up and just show some further social responsibility within the community. I know a practice that has donated medical supplies in the name of a pet that's gone to a human hospital, whether it be like face masks or whatever. And they just said, you know, dear Mrs. Smith, on behalf of Fluffy, we donated 5 surgical masks and a gown to XYZ hospital, just to let you know we're thinking of you all during this time, especially with pet owners that are related to other medical healthcare professionals too. And other practices that I've seen that have had, because in my area in New Jersey, we have a lot, unfortunately, of COVID parents with pets. And so they're sending out flowers, get well messages. The outpouring has been just enormous, you know. So, and the veterinary hospital is that emotional bond that they really rely on, just like you said.
This is really a time to keep your people employed by doing some of these gestures that you will sow now and reap later. Even things like, you know, maybe you have this list of clients that can't bring their pet in right now for the wellness. The last thing you want is to make them think you forgot. So send them, I'm a big fan of sending a bone box, a bark box, my own kind, where you can get a little bone and you get it in a little box and you write a little note. We're thinking of you, make good choices out there during COVID. You know, I address it to the pet. Dear Fluffy, make good choices. I'll see you in September. And drop that in the mail. But think about things we can do to keep top of mind and to be that resource and actually point of comfort for our community.
Yes. These are great, you guys. Such great tips from celebrity veterinarians and professionals too. And thank you for everything that you're doing out there for your communities, because none of it would be possible without you all. So thank you and your hospital teams. And thank you for your time today.
Thank you. It's so good to see all you guys.
You too.
to those that haven't seen our web episode before, we have to show one of our mugs to those to show everybody how human we really are. Dr. Sedge, what do you have?
Mine says, drink coffee, play some gangster rap, and handle it.
That's us.
That's us.
Dr. Kat, what do you have?
Hers is the best, I think.
You think? I love it. It says veterinary medicine because humans are gross.
Dr. DeWile.
Mine is one of my classmates drew Penny Pemphigus. And reminding me that she loves me. She always drew funny drawings on all of our vet school notes and our lesions, things we had to learn about. So she always turned them into cartoon characters and made us all mugs.
I love that. That's adorable. And this is mine. This one says, a truly great veterinarian is hard to find, difficult to part with, and impossible to forget. And this came from a pet owner, so she put the dog's name and the cat's name there. So it was really cute to kind of make you realize, man, we have a great profession. So, but thank you, everybody.
That's so nice.
It really is. It really is. And thank you, everybody, for tuning in. Hopefully you gained some valuable information. And if you haven't, checked our first webisode out about what we're talking about with regards to COVID-19 as well. And thank you, everybody. Have a good day. Stay healthy.
Bye, everyone.
Bye.